Bishop, we remember St. John Leonardi today. The glory of God and moral reform were two themes that were very prominent in his life.
Yes, what's fascinating, too, he is a friend of St. Philip Neri, the apostle of Rome, the reformer of Rome. So Leonardi, along with St. Joseph Calasanz, they're in this beautiful network of grace with St. Philip Neri. He was a great figure of reform, and I think his office of the readings, he has a letter to Pope Paul V. He writes, "Those who want to work for moral reform in the world must seek the glory of God before all else. Because he is the source of all good, they must wait for his help and pray for it in this difficult and necessary undertaking. They must then present themselves to those they seek to reform as mirrors of every virtue and as lamps on a lampstand. Their upright lives and noble conduct must shine before all who are in the house of God. In this way, they will gently entice the members of the church to reform instead of forcing them, lest in the words of the Council of Trent, they demand of the body what is not found in the head and thus upset the whole order of the Lord's household." I think in St. John Leonardi's letter to Pope Paul V, we see the basic insight that in the history of Catholic Church reform, it's charity that wins the day. It's not kind of bitter criticism. It's not something that is that's not draconian or kind of driving people to reform in some sort of ego-driven way. It's always church reform happens subtly, beautifully, through humility, holiness, mission. And St. John Leonardi, St. Philip Neri, St. Joseph Calasanz are great examples of it.
And let's hope today they pray for us.
Exactly.